One local family is mourning the death of a loved one, most likely because of a bite from a brown recluse spider. KMBC 9's Robb Yagmin joins us live with their story. Robb?
Well, Larry, I don't want to alarm you, but they are out there. They are in an area. In fact, they could be in your living room or possibly even your basement right now. Now, their bite, their venom isn't necessarily fatal, but one local family says if you get bit by a tick or a spider, go to the doctor immediately. It could be a decision that saves your life.
She was always one who was very humane with all animals.
Karen Miller loved the critters. In fact, of the 20 or so pictures her mother laid out for us, in about half, Karen was with a furry friend of some sort.
This is the dog in India. We were petting it, and then it bit her.
It's ironic that of all the worldly animals in all the photos, from the Egyptian camel to the Galapagos Island tortoise to the South African cheetah, it was here in Kansas City, a tiny insect the size of her pinky, which took her down.
Right here. And it looked like that, just two little fang marks.
A couple of Thursdays ago, Karen got out of her bed in her Prairie Village home and realized she had a bite on her leg. She shook out the sheets to no avail. She was put on two different antibiotics by doctors, but finally, 5 days after the bite,
I took her to St. Luke's ER, and she was almost comatose in 15 minutes.
Karen died 6 days later.
It was that fast.
It's unknown where the 52-year-old was when she got the bite. She trains horses, so it could have been a black widow, which was transferred here in the back of a horse trailer. But just yesterday, 8 days after her death, her husband found a brown recluse spider like this one in their kitchen sink.
The next day, a little bullseye in the middle. And when I said that, then they seemed to determine that was the brown recluse.
This type of spider is abundant in our area and distinguished by the violin-shaped marking on the top of its body. Its bite isn't fatal for all, but this time it could have been the culprit which brought this animal lover down.
Happy as a lark with the birds and the bees in heaven.
Now, one way to catch those spiders are these. They're called glue boards. They cost about $4. You get four of them at a local hardware store. What you do basically is you take the paper off it like this and then just stick it up under a couch or an armoire or a bed, and then the spiders walk across it and get stuck in the stickiness. And Larry, entomologists say that that's always a good idea to be able to, if you need to identify what exactly bit you or what is in your house. So those glue boards, $4, that's all.